Let's balance the redox reaction for Cu plus Ag plus, copper plus the silver ion. And we'll use these rules here to balance our redox reaction. If you need help with that, head over to my website. There's a guide for each one of these steps here to make sure you can balance redox reactions. So first, I'll write the oxidation numbers. In this case, they overlap with ionic charge. Not always the case, but it works out here. So the copper goes from 0 to plus 2, the silver plus 1 to 0. The way I think about it, we went from a plus 1 to 0, that got smaller. That's our reduction half reaction. Up here, it's going to have to be the oxidation half reaction. In fact, the number gets bigger, so that's oxidized. So now we can write those half reactions. So we have our oxidation reaction right here, and our reduction reaction. We want these to be balanced. So we have some rules to help us do that. First off, we balance the atoms. We have copper here, silver here, silver here. They're the same, so that's balanced. Then we would balance the oxygen atoms and the hydrogen atoms, but there aren't any. So we're done there. The last bit is to balance the charge by adding electrons. So here we have 2 plus, this is neutral. So let's add two negative charges, two electrons. Now this side is 0, and this side is 0. This half reaction is balanced. Over here we have a plus, so let's add a negative charge, just one electron here. This is 0, that's 0. We're done. We've balanced the half reactions. At this point, we have a bit of a problem, because the copper lost two electrons. The silver, it gained the electrons. But here we have two and just one, so that doesn't work out. That's not balanced. So we have to balance the overall equation for electrons, then we'll add the half reactions and simplify, and we'll have our balanced redox reaction. So what we can do, we have two electrons here, we could take and then multiply this entire half reaction by two. Then we have two electrons here, two here, and we'd be good. So let's do that, and that'll give us the balanced redox reaction. Here, on this side, these are the reactants up here. Do those first. Let's shrink this down some. We have our copper, then we have our two times these electrons, two times the silver ion. Those are the reactants. The products, they're over here. We have our Cu2 plus, our two electrons, and then two times the silver. And this is the balanced redox reaction for Cu plus Ag plus. What we'll do is cancel out things that are the same on both sides, those electrons. Let's get rid of those. Then we'll clean this up. You could write the states in if you want, and we're done. It's balanced. Check the atoms in the charge, copper, copper, two silvers, two silvers. We have two times one plus, that's two plus over here. We're done. That's it. This is Dr. B, balancing the redox reaction, copper plus the silver ion. Thanks for watching.